Hello world, it's Siraj, and the In My Feelings challenge is taking the internet by storm right now. People from all over the world are recording themselves dancing to Drake's latest song. So rather than dance myself, I've decided to submit an AI to do this dance challenge for me. Check out my demo. Track money, penny. This shit got me in my feelings. Gotta be real with it. Are you riding? Say you never. So how did I build a prototype so fast? Well, Google recently released the JavaScript version of their popular TensorFlow machine learning library, which inspired many easy-to-use browser-based demos. One in particular that caught my attention was the webcam-based PoseNet model. It uses a pre-trained neural network to create a real-time pose estimate of any human it sees. It was created by training on the Microsoft COCO, or Common Objects in Context, dataset. Microsoft gathered over 300,000 images that contained over 90 of the most common everyday objects, from cars to humans, and labeled each image extensively. Some of those labels were 14 human skeletal key points for each human in an image. So if a human appeared in an image, it would mark the positions of the human by describing the coordinates of the four corners of their bounding box. Then for each human, it denoted the coordinates of their left elbow, neck, and other body parts. MobileNet was a convolutional neural network trained on these images. Convolutional networks can learn how to mimic human vision and detect any particular object by learning a mapping between the input data and the given labels. They are a series of matrix operations applied to the input data to produce an output prediction. Those outputs are pretty bad at first, but by comparing its prediction to the labels, it measures how bad its prediction is and improves its next prediction for every new data point it sees until its prediction label is as good as its real label. PoseNet is a modified version of MobileNet, specifically for detecting human poses. It outputs a key point heat map and a set of offset vectors. Both are a matrix of values that correspond to a person's pose estimate. It uses a few extra matrix operations to retrieve the final confidence scores for each of the key points and then constructs a stick figure using them. I went ahead and found an example dance video from YouTube and held it up for the webcam to see as it played from my mobile phone. And I recorded my screen while the neural network made a pose estimate of the video that it saw playing. Once I had the screencast video, I cropped it so only the dance portion was visible, then applied a color mask to the video using Final Cut Pro. I just selected the color of the pose and applied the mask. It automatically removed all colors except the pose estimate's light blue, and voila, an AI that dances with no human. Of course, there's definitely a cleaner way to do this completely programmatically. First, since tensorflow.js can so easily apply pose estimates to every frame of a live webcam, the code can be modified so it applies it to a static video file on a desktop instead of a webcam. That static video could be any of the many dance challenge videos out there. And because it's in JavaScript, we can use any number of JS color processing libraries to apply a color mask to that video and isolate the AI. Now, ideally, we can create an AI that can uniquely dance to Drake by learning from these videos. This is definitely possible. In fact, my friend and fellow YouTuber, Kerry Huang, just released a video on a project he's been working on for a while. He trained a recurrent network to learn how to dance a specific style by creating his own dataset of dance moves. He took a YouTube video, split it up into many, many different frames, and fed it to a recurrent network. Because recurrent networks can learn sequences, it learned a generalized pattern for the dance moves it was fed, and eventually was able to dance in the style of what it was trained on. And now, wizards, I bring the challenge to you. Let's light up this dance challenge with our own AIs. Use any of the methods I've discussed to generate your own dancing AI and post a video of it on your favorite social media platform using the In My Feelings Challenge hashtag. This will raise awareness for this incredible technology and, in the process, bring hip hop into the future. Who knows? One of us might even get a mention from Drake. Good luck. Please subscribe for more programming videos. And for now, I've got to do the shiggy. So thanks for watching.